Tomlinson from the back row. Good return by Marr. But unfortunately for Mantha, couldn't keep it in. Mantha, one of the top players in the conference. He's fifth in the conference in scoring. Tomlinson second. So they're the two stars on display, if you will, to start this match. And an ace by Brunette. Campion Smith for McMaster is their captain and setter. Sets it up, and blocked there was Demianko. Right now sets Edwards. Good recovery by Demianko. Back row, Goyer, blocked by Demianko. Second year player out of Toronto, 6'5". Making some good defensive plays there for McMaster. Campion Smith back to serve. Goyer per pass. But the Gaels will set up again. Trent's tip. Mantha right there. Back row and hammering it was Marr.
So far, I'm very impressed with the strength of the McMaster blocks. Seems like they're able to absorb just about everything that the Gaels are throwing at them.
Dramov, right, Trent, hammers it. We've seen in previous men's volleyball matches, opponents of the Gaels serve at Philip Goyer. That seems to be McMaster's train of thought here early in this match. Right to serve for the Gaels, who trail by a point. Short set, hammered by Demianko.
That's a great cut out of the middle, tagging the line just above the attack line.
Dave Preston, the head coach of McMaster, longtime head coach in Hamilton. Brenda Willis, the longtime coach of the Queens Gaels, and will be inducted in the Kingston and District Hall of Fame this May. Good pass by Trentz. Good kill by Trentz. Back-to-back points for the Gaels hitter. Trance. Good pass by Ski, and the hit by McMaster goes out. So the Gaels have tied things up at five. Trance to serve again. A lot of power. Good pass. Back row and a block, and the Gaels will get the point, I think. It's a backcourt attack, yes, on Mantha.
Gaels take the lead.
Ooh, a soft serve this time by Trentz. Good save by Marr. Goyer. Set for Herbert. Off the block and out, but it's a point for McMaster. Elliot returns as the libero Yenjaevsky goes to the bench. Poor pass by Goyer.
Service ace to the Marauders. Go return from the Gaels. Back retakes the lead.
Demianko. Right, Goyer, good hit.
Goyer gets up over top of the block. Sends it at seven.
Set, a short one. Good play by Edwards. Goyer's blocked, and then the ricochet hit him in the leg, and so McMaster gets the point.
Touching down on the Gaels side of the net.
Herbert to serve. Tomlinson blocked. And a great block by Marr and Elliott. Herbert, second year out of Mississauga. This is a young, surprisingly young McMaster team. Only one fifth-year player as Goyer killed that one. Only Tyson Alexander out of Shanty Bay, Ontario, is playing his last year of eligibility.
It's got to make you nervous if you're any other team in the OUA.
And the serve out by Tomlinson. The risk reward of the Tomlinson serve. And this time it's a risk and gives McMaster the serve back. Marr to serve. Wow.
Serve comes from Stephen Marr.
That serve came almost straight down.
I was going to say, like, it's almost like he's over the net when he hits it.
Yeah, most people would be happy if their backcourt attacks were able to come that steep down.
Marr again. Wow. Good work by Brunette to get it back over. And from the back row. My, oh my.
Uses all of his 6'8 frame to hit from an incredible height. And the amount of power, the snap that he gets on the ball is scary.
Second year out of Aurora, Ontario. Clips the net. Back row, Tomlinson's blocked. Goyer off the block. So it's 12-9 McMaster. And right now, early on defensively, it looks like McMaster's ready for Tomlinson, and maybe there's some room to exploit for Phil Goyer.
Yeah, that's true. A lot of blocks going up against Tomlinson.
Obviously, being the second leading scorer in the OUA. As McMaster gets the side out. And send Elliott back to serve.
Hard to believe that Marr is only third on the McMaster team in terms of kills this year.
Mantha really hasn't done much early on in this first set, and he's their top scorer. This is a team, though, that's only lost 10 sets all season. And half of those are to Waterloo. Yeah. Two of them were to Western, and then a couple of sets here or there. But it does seem like Waterloo presents them with the toughest challenge so far this season. Herbert, that's out. Gaels are within a point.
No touch call on the swing from the Marauders. Brunette serving.
Out with the serve by Brunette. Campion Smith. Goyer, good pass. Right. Tomlinson from the back row with the tip. And Jendrzejewski tried his best, but couldn't make the save. Right to serve. Gaels down a point. Tipped by Mantha for the point off the block. He gets up there too.
Yeah, an incredible vertical on him.
Again, if it's your first time watching volleyball, at first team to 16 points takes us to a technical timeout each set, other than the fifth set where the technical timeout comes at 8 and is really just a switch of sides. Mantha crushes that serve. Herbert puts in the return that goes over the net, and will go to the technical timeout with McMaster up 3 and doing it in clinical fashion, Peter.
Yeah, it almost feels like it's a wider gap than just 3 points. Seems like most of the highlights from the first half of this first set have been great McMaster kills, and we haven't seen anything stand out from the Gaels, and yet they've found a way to stay in the set so far.
Gaels go to RMC tomorrow. We'll play an afternoon doubleheader with the Paladins. The women will play first, followed by the men. McMaster won in three straight at RMC last night to improve their record to 15-1. So a win tonight, or this afternoon by McMaster, would put them 6 points up on Waterloo and Western, and they have the tiebreaker on both teams. So pretty much they've almost locked up first. First and second get you a bye to the semifinals. And obviously, getting first avoids Waterloo and Western in the semifinals and forces those two teams, which seem to be the next two challengers, to have to play each other in the semis. Gaels are just trying to make the playoffs, and right now they hold the tiebreaker on Windsor, who they're tied with for sixth. But they do have matches left with the two bottom teams in the conference, RMC and Toronto, in the next 8 days. Mantha just clipped the net. Good reaction by Wright. Trance will give the free ball. Where's Marr? Doesn't matter because Demianko. Demianko with a great kill. And McMaster extends the lead to four. Mantha tried to take something off of it and put it into the net. You'll see a lot more errors in the men's game, Peter, than you would have in our previous match, the women's match, just because of the sheer power being put into these serves.
Yeah, a lot more room for error in these men's serves. So many aspects go into a jump spin serve that a lot of the men opt to go for.
Aaron Neusbaum comes in to serve, takes Trentz out. Demianko with the kill. Gaels just can't get any rhythm offensively because the McMaster offense doesn't allow you. Sayar Karimi comes in for Demianko and will serve. Elliott's returned up front. Blocked but out, and the Gaels will get the point. Brunette returns, and Glantz will come in, the captain of the Gaels, to replace Elliott in the back row. And he'll serve. Yenjaevsky returns at the libero spot for McMaster. Did not catch the line. Mantha right beside the official there. It was close. But the call goes McMaster's way. Herbert, and that goes way out. McMaster looks like they're going to make some subs, as Dave Preston hands the paddles to a couple of players on the bench. Herbert looks to be one of the players coming off. Marr, Tomlinson back row with the tip. Good play, Yenjaevsky. Herbert, Gaels, set, Brunette! Off the short, set by Wright. And in for McMaster will come Jason McCarthy, second year out of Oshawa. And also Andrew Coker, number three, second year out of Toronto, and they take out the setter Campion Smith and Herbert. Tomlinson into the net. Both his serves have been errors. Mac leading by three. And that serve goes out by Marr. So he built up his serve the last time he served. Now both teams with some, a little too amped up. And Goye back. He usually floats it across. Coker sets. Mantha crushes. Not bad when you got two setters like Coker and Campion Smith.
Yeah, this Gaels, or the McMaster squad has so many weapons, it's impossible for Queens to predict where they'll go next.
Trentz, he kills it. Edwards returns, and we'll take out Glantz. Brunette back to serve. Gaels trail by two. Oh, Marr didn't expect to have to make the play. He's going to have to send over a free ball. Oh, poor pass, Goye. And Edwards is blocked, but Wright was in the net. And that started with a poor pass by Goye.
Yeah, Phil Goye will be, sure, a little bit upset with himself after that. Should have made a better play on that pass after a free ball.
McCarthy back to serve for McMaster. They're 3 points from the first set. Good pass, Dramoff. Edwards, and that hits McCarthy right in the face. They call that a pancake in this sport. Crowd giving him a hard time. McCarthy turns to the crowd, gives him a thumbs up. Coker, McCarthy, Dramov, good play, right. Tomlinson from the back row, and it's out. Struggle right now for Mike Tomlinson in the first set. Just can't get going. McMaster has made it clear they're going to take him out of the game and dare the other Gaels to beat them. Mantha back to serve. Good pass, Trentz. Trentz with the kill. McCarthy couldn't keep it in. You wonder how much he's thinking of that other kill and trying to protect himself. And the Gaels are within two with Trentz going back to serve. Oh, he mishit it.
Service error coming from Trentz.
And another Gaels service error. And like that, it's three set points for the Marauders. You can't do this when you're playing one of the best teams in the country. Demienko to serve. Good save, Trentz. Can Tomlinson get it over? No. First set to McMaster. 25-21, but we said at the technical timeout, seemed a lot easier.
Yeah, it didn't seem like the Gaels were ever really challenging to win that set. They were close the whole time, but you never got the feeling that Queens might come away with a win in that first set. McMaster, really a dominant team. We saw their skill showcased in that first set.
Okay, send out some shouts to our sponsors as we get set for the second set. The Queens University Alumni Association, students for a short time, alumni for a lifetime. AMS, they're hiring for next year, and all that information will come out soon. And the Yearbook and Design Services, we'll be talking soon about where you can pick up your yearbooks. Also want to mention that there's a night doubleheader to follow here on this Super Saturday. I'll be back for a 6 p.m. tip-off of the women's basketball game against Laurentian, followed by the men tipping off at 8. I'll be joined by Rachel Orosevic for that, and there's what you're seeing about AMS hiring for next year. And you can see the application deadlines right there on your screen. And before the women's basketball game, there'll be an interview with Robin P. McPherson from the women's basketball team, one of the top rebounders in the country, and a critical part of why the Gaels are looking at finishing second or third in the OUA East and maybe even first.
And apparently a volleyball fan as well, as she's sitting just across the net.
She is, if our cameras can find her in the front row there with Emily Haslett and Jenny Wright from the women's basketball team, because they'll be playing with a 6 p.m. tip-off time, as I said. And then, a reminder as well, as viewers might have gotten you a little confused during the women's game. When this match is over, of course, remember that you'll have to go and refresh and log into a different game broadcast for the basketball game. But if you're joining us now, you're looking at the huddle of the best team in Ontario right now, and they've been that way for the last bunch of years, the McMaster Marauders, and you see their fine coach there, Dave Preston, and boy, oh boy, he's got a solid team, and they look like they should be nearing the end of their volleyball career at McMaster, but other than one player, they'll all be back next year. And there's the Gaels trying to huddle, trying to figure out how they can stop this steamroller. Coker is going to start this second set for McMaster as the setter, and McCarthy stays in, as does the only fifth year on the team, Tyson Alexander, who is starting this set. The Gaels keep their starting six of Goyer, Brunette, Trent, Edwards, Tomlinson, Dramov as the libero. Yenjaevsky is the libero and switches with Demianko. It'll be Marr to serve first. Second set, McMaster took the opening set 25-21. Watch the height Stephen Marr gets on this. Tomlinson, there you go. Gaels need that big time if they're going to survive this match.
Cross court swing gets the Gaels on the board first.
Yeah, it's the first time where we've seen a good smooth attack, I think, from Mike Tomlinson in this match.
Edwards to serve. Coker from the back row, Marr. And did Marr go over the line? He did.
Marr's called on the match.
So the Gaels get the first 2 points of this second set. Coker sets for Mantha, who gets blocked by Tomlinson. So the two of the top five leading scorers in the conference there at the net. Deep serve. Coker sets. That goes off the net, or did it go off the block? Apparently the block. McCarthy gets the point. McMaster fortunate there. It looked from our angle, Peter, like it might have hit the net.
Yeah, it might have. The net might have stopped it, but I think the Gaels player is just getting a finger on it to keep the play alive for McMaster.
Alexander with the serve. Goyer with the rollover. And it surprised McMaster.
Good misdirection from Philip Goyer as he made as if he would slam a cross-court ball down before a clever roll shot.
Tomlinson to serve. Over. Good pass by Marr. Short set. McCarthy hammers it. That was a great play.
Yeah, the Gaels had to respect the fake put up by Demianenko in the middle. And just great misdirection again.
McCarthy back to serve. Good serve, Dramov, a nice pass. Goyer mishit it, but he just caught the line, the changeup, as they'd say in baseball, just caught the corner. And Goyer goes back to serve with the Gaels up three early, and Goyer has a little chuckle with his bench about that kill, if you want to call it that. Deep serve for an ace.
And the serve for the Gaels, touching the back line. Queens extending the lead to 4-6-2. Goyer's serve.
Philip Goye, perhaps trying to tag all the lines here in three plays.
Mantha, Mar, Mantha, out.
No touch call on the time for Mantha.
McMaster, I think, thought it might have tipped the block. The line judge does not agree. Dave Preston's forced to use a timeout here as it's 6-3, and I think it's more just to wake up the group he's got on the floor. It's not his starting unit, but it's still a group I think he expects to be playing a little crisper than this.
Yeah, a lot of mistakes early on here for McMaster. Hitting long, not quite calling balls, whether they're in or out.
And in fact, a lot of this discussion, Preston's not even in the huddle, is just the players sort of talking to each other about what they're seeing out there. That's a pretty confident coach when you don't even need to go into the huddle.
Yeah, that's a sign of trust in the players you have on the floor.
Goye back to serve. It's 7-2. Not 6-3 for the Gaels. Mantha, tip. Tomlinson able to get to it. Goye has to send over the free ball. Coker, nice set to McCarthy.
Coker goes back and forth.
That's a great play by Coker.
It's hard to believe that he wasn't the starting setter with the precision he's put into his set so far.
Mantha back to serve. Good return by the Gaels. Brunet has to push it over. Poor set. And Trentz, did he go over the net? He did.
Interference call on the Gaels. Point to the Marauders.
Fortunate there for the Marauders. They get a point out of that because it wasn't the prettiest of plays. But they'll take it. Mantha. Holy smokes. Trentz blocked and it hit him. Damienko with the block.
That comes from Trentz. It goes into the hands of the Marauder blocker, but back over the net. The point for McMaster.
So just like that, two straight points off the Mantha serve. Three straight points for the Marauders, and they're back to within two. They give the point on the block to Coker, in fact. Good serve again by Mantha. Tomlinson off the block. McCarthy, great job. Marr hits it over. Right. Trentz off the block. Good defense by McMaster, but the Gaels eventually get the point.
Yeah, really good rally so far.
Brunette to serve for the Gaels, who lead by three. We're early second set. McMaster took the first set. Coker, McCarthy from the back row, and it's out. Again, the players think it went off the block. But Dave Preston, their head coach, certainly isn't arguing and talks to Coker there about where to set maybe next time. This time, Marr. And that time, the block can't get it back over. Alexander checks back into the front row. Demianko to serve. Goye, not a great pass. Trentz rolls it over, but Marr read that. McCarthy. Tomlinson. And that got the floor before Mantha could get to it.
Tomlinson starting to come alive here much more in the second set than he could in the first set.
Right back to serve. The first year setter out of Kingston. Hometown boy. Good hit by Alexander off the short set by Coker. Not much could be done about that. Poker will go back to serve. Goyer, right. Edwards just pushed it over.
Edwards
found the spot.
Over top of the block. Point for the Gaels, who lead 11-7.
Trent's back to serve now. Gaels lead by four. Good serve, good pass. Coker. And McCarthy, good adjustment in the air and put it down the line. That wasn't what he was initially going to do, nor set to do. And Marr now goes back to serve. There'll be some heat on this serve. Good set by Wright, and Tomlinson puts it off the block. But Wright made that possible.
Definitely a good thing for Queens to get out of that rotation quickly. You don't want Meyer going on a roll with those.
Jamie Wright, of course, and that's a lift on Mantha. So just like that, the Gaels go up five. Jamie Wright, of course, the younger brother of the Gaels basketball player, Jenny Wright, who we'll see in our next game. That, in the broadcast biz, is called a segue.
Over the net, interference call on Coker. Substitution.
And Mantha's going to come out as Coppers comes in.
Edwards back to serve for Queens.
Edwards. McCarthy, good play by Trent, and a nice reaction by Tomlinson. Coppers, and it hit the antenna.
Tackle Coppers goes out of bounds.
Coppers in his first year from Georgetown, Ontario. So another freshman in the lineup for the Marauders, who trail by seven right now in this second set. Coppers, McCarthy, off the block and in.
Jason McCarthy in response with back.
Demienko returns. And Karimi will come in to serve. Shows you that even the non-6'5 guys can play this sport. Karimi came in the last set for serving. Gaels a point away from taking us to the second set technical timeout. And that'll happen. I build up Karimi. And he puts it into the net. So the Gaels lead 16-9 as we head to the second technical timeout. And Dave Preston, very calm right now on the McMaster bench. When your team, Peters, only lost 10 sets, I guess they've earned the right for calmness.
Yeah, it's interesting to see. I mean, obviously, they have no need to be panicked. They know that they can come back and win this game. But this is a situation that McMaster hasn't been in very much this year. And you'd think that might play on them a little bit.
They've lost five games. Five of their 10 set losses were to Waterloo. Another two to Western. And then one to Ryerson in each of their meetings with the Rams. And one to York, but that's it. Those are the only teams that have taken sets off them, and Waterloo's the only team that's taken a match off of the Marauders.
And if you look at the OUA standings, those are all of the teams that are sitting above Queens right
yeah.
now in the standings.
So can the Gaels join that group?
Perhaps that's what it takes to be part of the OUA elite this year.
And to make the playoffs.
Being able to take a set off of McMaster.
Tomlinson back to serve as we start after the second set technical timeout. McMaster took the first set, 25-21. Tomlinson into the net.
Tomlinson.
His third service error. He comes out, replaced by Thomas Ellison.
Marauders substitution.
And also in comes Tyler Shearhorn, who replaces Jamie Wright. We saw this in the women's match, so it'll mean that Ellison will become the setter. Shearhorn stays up front in the front row. And Campion Smith returns for Coker, and he'll serve. So lots of changes there. Ellison, Goyer, blocked. Demianko. See if that gets McMaster going. They're within five. And you worry here, the Gaels with a very young lineup on the floor. Can they protect the lead? Ellison, nice set. And Brunet with a nice hit. Adjusted himself in midair and made sure it went off the block and out. Goyer back to serve. Herbert, off the block and out.
Herbert, the left side attack for Mac. Both Marauders within five. Coppers to serve.
Coppers, great serve, but a good recovery by the Gaels to get it over. But Demianko puts it in.
Touch the middle, goes to Demianko.
Gaels did some good scrambling, but McMaster made them pay.
Demianko has been a force for McMaster in the middle. He's been tagging both sidelines with his cuts.
Set. Trentz rolls it over and in.
Ball shot from Marcus Trentz goes through the block.
And Edwards will return as Brunette goes back to serve. Gaels trying to hit the turn at 20 points first. And they're close to doing it. Marr off the block, and Ellison couldn't make the play. Alexander returns for the Marauders to the front row. And Dramov comes back in at the libero spot. Demianko. Ellison tracks it down. Trentz just clipped the block. Marr. Ellison. Trentz. Good return by Coppers, but out.
Marcus Trentz in the left side attack. Goes off, arms out of bounds.
Tomlinson and Wright both come back into the game. Good minutes from Ellison. As Wright goes back to serve. Gaels lead 19-14. Set, short one for Alexander, and that got buried. Pretty good crowd starting to fill into the arc as they get ready for the basketball doubleheader in the tail end of this. Mantha, I think, is supposed to, might have been warned that he was too close to the sideline. Herbert to serve. Right. Edwards, boom! Great short set by Jamie Wright.
Aaron Nussbaum back in for Gaels.
Nussbaum will come in to serve for Trentz, who's had some struggles back there. Nussbaum. Gaels hit the 20 mark first in this set. They lead by five. They're that far away from evening the match. Alexander again off a nice set by Campion Smith. Marr back to serve. Gaels are ready for some heat on this serve. That's why his fingers are taped, and you can see that there on your screen. Into the net.
Short serve from Stephen Marr.
That's a break for the Gaels.
Also a break for his teammates in the front row as he almost took their heads off.
Yeah. Dave Preston still elects not to use his last time out. Gaels 4 points from the set. Alexander, oh, nice saves by the Gaels. Poor set to Alexander, right. Goye got the point. Campion Smith mad at himself. He missed Alexander with the set, and Coppers had to put over the free ball, and the Gaels took advantage, and they're 3 points away from the set. Coppers off the block. And Demianko will come back in. Alexander with the serve, right, short set, and Brunette finishes it. Gaels finding some rhythm, and the rookie setter's finding it for them. Tomlinson back to serve. It's been a struggle back there for him. Gaels leading 23-17. Out. The struggles continue. Campion Smith to serve. Right. Goye, did it hit the block? No.
Touch goes wide.
McMaster closes to within four.
Smith to serve.
Right. Short set, pushed over, but Brunet, no, they'll say McMaster was on the net.
Marauders call on the net.
So Trentz returns for Nussbaum. Goye goes back to serve. Gaels have 5 set points. Good serve. Demianko, great play by Coppers to start that offensive play. And he'll go back to serve. McMaster staving off one of the 5 set points. Gaels still possesses set point. Right. Trentz, tip, out.
No touch on the tip from Trentz. Ball's wide, out of bounds. Timeout.
And the Gaels will use a timeout. Just to calm down, they're a point away from the set.
It's interesting that we see the Gaels take a timeout here and McMaster content not to take one.
And still with Mantha on the bench. And again, no Dave Preston in the huddle during this timeout and really talking to Stephen Marr, the second year player out of Aurora. Now he gives some words, but I think it's got to be an advantage to the Marauders to have such a calm influence on their sideline. We know the great virtues as a coach of Dave Preston. This program he's built at McMaster is top notch. And sometimes he just lets his players ride it out. Coppers to serve. Right. Trentz blocked. Good recovery. They'll try Trentz again. Off the block, they hit the net.
Touch ball on the attack. Trentz goes into the antenna.
No, it hit the antenna, so McMaster staves off another set point.
You're saying Dave Preston, a calm head coach? Brenda Willis also pretty
yes.
calm. Not very
yeah.
excitable on the Gaels sideline
no, good
either.
Point. And she's built an excellent, excellent program and was there before Dave Preston started his work at McMaster. Great point. Off the block. Campion Smith, Demianko, good tip. Goye, great save. Wright is blocked, but it's going to allow the Gaels to run another play. Trentz, off the block. Can they get it? No! The Gaels even the match. And for the first time this season, they take a set off the champs. They win it 25-22. And that's what you need if you're the Gaels, Peter.
Yeah, that's just... I mean, if you're, you, if they got out to a good lead early, the Gaels did. And if you're going to have any shot at beating a squad as good as McMaster, you have to be able to protect that lead once you get it.
So, chance to extend some thanks to our sponsors, Queen's University Alumni Association, who's bringing you these broadcasts live from the Arc, students for a short time, alumni for a lifetime. Also, the Queen's AMS. They're hiring for next year. The yearbook and design services. Pick up your yearbook, as you saw there, room 32. And there's the application deadlines for hiring for the AMS. They're looking for numerous positions. And a reminder that an interview with Robin Pearson is to come before the women's basketball game that will tip off at 6 between Laurentian and Queens. Myself and Rachel Rosevic will bring you that basketball doubleheader. If you're just joining us, women's volleyball loses in 5 sets to McMaster. The men playing right now as we head to the pivotal 3rd set have evened the match at a set apiece. McMaster coming into today in men's play atop the OUA at 15-1. The Gaels tied for 6th with a record of 6-10. They have the tiebreaker on Windsor, but an upset of McMaster would go a long way in securing that 6th spot. They'd be on the road for the playoffs, but they'd be in the playoffs. They'd have a table at the dinner table, or a seat at the dinner table. And you never, never know.
If they can take a win away from today's match against McMaster, then that gives them a ton of confidence going into the playoffs. Obviously, being at the bottom, you know you're going to get one of the harder teams above you, but if you can beat McMaster, you can beat anybody in the OUA.
And it would certainly give Waterloo and Western keep their glimmer of hope alive that they could somehow steal first place from McMaster, though the odds on that are remote at best. So the Marauders send out Demianko, Campion, Smith, Coppers, Herbert, Alexander, and Marr to start. Gaels with their consistent starters from today. Brunette, Trentz, Wright, Edwards, Goyer, and Tomlinson. The liberos for the Gaels, Dramov, and for the Marauders, it's Yenjaevsky. Gaels will serve first. It'll be Goyer back. Marcus Trentz leading the way for the Gaels in scoring through 2 sets. Demianko off the block. Gaels keep it alive. Back row, Tomlinson. Coppers rolls it over. Dramov's there. Tomlinson back row off the block, and no one can get it.
Tomlinson back row attack getting the Gaels on the board.
And the Gaels definitely on that first point of this set, Peter, look like they have some momentum to carry from that second set. Some energy, some belief. Coppers, nice hit. Got it around the block and misfooted Tomlinson.
Marauders on the board.
Campion Smith to serve. Goyer, right, sets, Brunette. And they've clicked on that short set in the middle. Have Wright and Brunette. And Brunette goes back to serve. Deep one. Herbert blocked. Free ball for the Gaels. Trentz off the block. Back row, Marr into the net.
Smith goes to Marr. Attack goes into the net. Point, Queens.
And the serve out by Brunette. As you said right in the opening, Peter, can't have too many service errors if you're the Gaels and you hope to pull off the upset.
No, that was one thing they did a pretty good job of in the last set. Not very many service errors coming from the Gaels side.
Coppers with the serve. Edwards pounds the short set. Jamie Wright is clicking right now at that setter spot.
Definitely showing why he's earned his playing time.
Marr blocked. Trentz off the block. But Herbert, I think, hit it twice. So it's 5-2 Gaels, and Wright goes back to serve again. Marr, and that time no one was blocking that one.
Queen's doing a pretty good job of limiting the number of points, the big names for McMaster tonight. Nobody running away with the game.
Alexander takes advantage of the poor Goyer pass and gets a point for McMaster. And the top scorer for McMaster, Joey Mantha, has been on the bench since early in the second set. Serve out by Demianko. Gaels needed that unforced error, in which they go back up by two. Trentz just clips the net. Wright might have hit it twice. Alexander, and the return by Trentz is going to go out. Gaels might have gotten away with a double hit. It looked like Wright bumped it into his face, and that, if I'm not mistaken, would have been a double hit, would it not?
Yeah, the rule is if it's in one motion, like if the ball rolls up you, then it doesn't count as a double hit, but I definitely agree it should have been a double hit, as it seemed to be two distinct touches.
Just caught the line, the official was putting up his flag, then put it down and was overruled by the tower. So McMaster's come back to tie it at six. Herbert. Tomlinson blocked but out.
Tomlinson goes into the block off the hands of Alexander and Barr.
Brunette returns to the front row for the Gaels. Edwards back to serve. Alexander off the block. Wright sets for Goyer. Blocked. Tomlinson keeps it alive. Trentz. Edwards can just get it over. Marr blocked by Tomlinson. Alexander's blocked by Brunette. My oh my. Gaels with some great defense there. And they follow it up with a service error by Edwards.
Ball possession back to the Marauders.
Marr back to serve. Early third set. Tomlinson blocked. He was too close to the net, and Coppers rejected him.
And that started off that incredible serve by Marr.
And a pretty good pass by Goyer. We've been remarking about Goyer struggling with that, but that was a great pass. Goyer with a good save, and they just get it over, but it just sets up Alexander. And right now, Stephen Marr's got to serve on the money right now. And the Marauders are out in front by a point. And he puts that one out.
Service error for
Now Tomlinson back to serve. He has struggled, to say the least, serving. Floats it. Great set by Campion Smith, and Alexander finding his stride.
You can tell Tomlinson struggling with his serves when he opts to float it. That almost never happens.
Just wanting to get it over the net. Good pass, Goye. Right, Brunette. I said it earlier, this set, they're clicking on that short set in the middle. Hoppers, not a good pass, and they'll chalk it up as an ace for Goye. Blocked, but out. Demianko just powered that off the block.
Yeah, that was a really good one-handed set there by Campion Smith as he saved it from going over the net.
And Campion Smith back to serve. Floats it out.
Serves error from Smith.
And for the first time, you see some emotion from Dave Preston on the McMaster bench. He doesn't like what he's seeing in these unforced errors by his team. Brunette to serve. Demianko, my goodness.
The middles for both teams have been some of the most consistent players offensively, but the McMaster hits out of the middle, just such force, so straight down.
Right, sets for Edwards, and he caught the line. No, they say Edwards. Did they say Edwards? No, I was got thrown off by the referee's signal there for a second, but the Gaels do retain the serve. Right to serve. Mahar! Wow!
The teams right now even and trading points, but when McMaster scores, their attacks are just so much cleaner.
Demianko. Goye, back row, Trent, Edwards against the block. Good save by Marr, and then Coppers. Gaels have a free ball to use. Back row, Goye right off Demianko, and no one's saving that for McMaster.
With the amount of effort we're seeing both teams put in on defense, I think it might come down to who can keep that up the longest to see who comes away with the match.
Back row, Coppers. Nice play, Trent. Free ball for McMaster. Short set, and Alexander makes the play. You almost get the sense that if these setters keep doing the short sets, that's money.
Yeah, I mean, I'm waiting for one team to commit a triple block in the middle.
Right. Goye off the block and out. 15-14 Gaels lead, close to the technical timeout for the third set. Short set, Alexander for the kill. It's a broken record right now. So after this serve, we'll go to the technical timeout in this third set. Really having solved nothing. No one has really taken control yet in this pivotal middle set. Right, good hustle to get it to Goye, but he hit it out. So McMaster gets to 16 first, but as I said, Peter, nothing settled. It's only a one-point lead.
Yeah, both teams really trading points in the third set. And I'm just surprised that McMaster isn't taking control of this set and control of the match.
And you wonder how long they can go with Joey Mantha on the bench.
Yeah, he seemed to provide so much, such a presence on the court when he was on there. Obviously with his skill, but also just keeping things together, I felt.
Gaels lost the first set 25-21, won the second set 25-22, and we're in a close third set. The women's match went five very exciting sets, and we've still got a women's and men's basketball doubleheader to follow. All this courtesy of Queens TV and the Queens University Alumni Association, students for a short time, alumni for a lifetime. Gaels come in 6-10, McMaster 15-1. Their only loss last Saturday at Waterloo, they lost in five sets. They ended that brief one-game losing streak last night with a three-set sweep of RMC. What will they do today? Marr. Tomlinson blocked. They were ready for that one, Alexander and Coppers. And you almost think that they've got to go away from Tomlinson or do something to try and... And Brenda Willis saying something to Tomlinson. Maybe to just that, to try and change something up for him. Marr, what a serve. Right. Tomlinson, nobody went for it. And just like that, McMaster goes up three. And they're going to call a timeout. Brenda Willis will call a timeout. She senses her team struggling a little bit on offense. To say the least.
I think the Gaels have to get back to their middles if they want to score a point. But you need a good set to set, or a good pass to set your middle, and hard to get a good pass off of these ridiculous serves.
Well, and the other thing is they seem to have gone away from Goyer. They're trying to, and I acknowledge it's a great idea. Let's get Tomlinson back in the game, start to get him to be a force. But at the same time, you're quelling the momentum that Goyer had established. It's an interesting conundrum you're in if you're Brenda Willis. Your best player, the second top scorer in the OUA, is not having his type of day. You're trying to get him going, but at the same time, you're taking away some of that other offense. Marr to serve again, and as you also pointed out so well, these Marr serves, you don't have a lot of time to think. Holy smokes! Ace! Best serve I've seen this year.
Yeah, I'm just waiting for Ivo Dramov's arms to fall off one of these times as he takes the pass.
Hopefully that won't happen. It would be messy and gross to say the least, but these things are coming at warp speed. Took a little off of that one. Brunet, good recovery, Herbert. Coppers, and Trent probably should have let it go. And Dramov, I think, was trying to scream out, but it's easier said than done when it's coming that fast. You don't have a lot of time to think. And speaking of fast and not a lot of time to think, he's back to serve again, Stephen Marr. Kaboom. Nice play, Herbert. Coppers. And it's a point for McMaster. They need another timeout. Do the Gaels, because the Marauders are rolling. They'll try and slow things down with a towel and wipe up a sweat spot. 21-15, Marauders lead. It was 16-15. With Marr back to serve. And he's been back there since. Pivotal third set. If you're going to beat the best, you almost need to get this set. And right now, the Gaels are in a corner. Marr, and that one he couldn't get down.
He chuckles. Crowd gives, Queens crowd gives him a hard time. But he's done his damage. It's 21-16. Tomlinson's going to come out. He's just struggled too much serving back there. Ellison will go back to serve. Wright comes out. And now Holmes comes in to go to the front row. This is more just to get a different server in there. Ellison. The set. Alexander gets blocked by Brunette. Good read by Brunette. Didn't get fooled by the no-look set. And the Gaels are hanging around. Ellison. Coppers right through the block. Demienko returns. Elliott is going to come in for Alexander to serve. Marauders 3 points from the third set, which would leave them a set from the match. Holmes off the block and out. Gaels need to string some points together. And Goyer's back to serve. Still no Joey Mantha for McMaster on the floor. Still on the bench. Back row and Marr mistimed it. Might have been more on the set, as Marr had to make sure he stayed behind the attack line to take off, and the Gaels are within three. Hit by Damienko, just powered it off the block. Gaels can't get it back. And Campion Smith will go back to serve. 13 points for Damienko in this one. McMaster, 2 points from the set. Brunette mistimed his jump. Coppers got it in. 5 set points for the Marauders to take a 2-1 lead. No timeouts left for the Gaels, so Brenda Willis just has to hope her young team can make a comeback. Goyer, Ellison, Trentz, Damienko off the block. Ellison, Holmes rolls it over. Back row, Marr, and he hit it into the net. Set. Coppers powers it down. It's 2 sets to 1, McMaster. Not even a well-played set maybe by the Marauders, but they still won it with relative ease, like similar to the first set.
Yeah, it's true. We're definitely not seeing the best of McMaster's volleyball. Queens just sticking around and capitalizing on a few of McMaster's mistakes to keep themselves in the game. But the difference in that set was Stephen Marr's serving. That's really what pulled the Marauders ahead and what gave them the chance to win the set.
You surprised where you haven't seen Joey Mantha back yet, or is it just one of those situations where Dave Preston's got the luxury that he doesn't have to put his top player in because they're doing just fine?
Yeah, I think he's definitely taking advantage of this being a close game and giving some other players the valuable minutes of having experience in a close game where every point does matter.
For the Gaels, what's Brenda Willis talking to her young team about, because they can't lose another set?
No, well, definitely limiting their errors, certainly service errors, but then playing smart, because McMaster's put up a number of really big blocks in front of them, and Queens has a few times just hit into it blindly. I think the Gaels players need to be a little more talkative to give each other as much advice as they can on the floor, calling out how many people are up for the block, and just placing balls a little bit more than swinging at them relentlessly.
You see the McMaster huddle there, and a lot, and again, you don't want to question probably one of the greatest coaches in men's volleyball in the OUA for the last 20 years in Brenda Willis, but they did seem to get away from the, as you said, the short set in the middle from away from Goyer to try and get Tomlinson going, and it seemed to have the reverse effect. It got McMaster going and got them enough of a gap they could just ride it to win the set.
Yeah, Queens, I think they have to be smarter at picking their hitters. They can't just go to necessarily their best player. They have to go to who has the best opportunity to score a point in that situation. So whether that is Marcus Trent, Scott Burnett, Darren Edwards, whoever it is on the floor, they have to find them instead of just going to their best player, most dangerous player, Mike Thompson.
Parrish Offer, there you see, the Kingston native, Regiopolis grad, longtime McMaster, great player, now an assistant coach on Dave Preston's squad, trying to get his team pumped up to try and end this in four sets. It would certainly, a four-set match, would keep us on schedule for the girls' basketball game to tip off at 6. So from a broadcast scheduling point of view, in four sets would be nice, but from a Queens point of view, it'd be nice to see the Gaels win the last two sets. Good tip by Tomlinson off the bat.
Yes, these long volleyball games definitely going to provide some havoc for the home event staff trying to set up for the basketball game.
Ah, Super Saturdays. Nice hit by Coppers. He's really come on here in the last few minutes. Tail end of the third set and here on this first second point of the fourth set. We've got another Super Saturday for you next week on February 8th. When it's Ryerson for a volleyball doubleheader against the Gaels. And a basketball doubleheader to follow. Tomlinson, and that just got away from him. It's been that type of afternoon for Mike Tomlinson. No question he's going to be an all-star this year in the OUA. No question he's one of the best players in the conference. But he'd like to wake up from this nightmare and start again today. Right, Goyer, blocked out.
Yeah, I think you can tell that McMaster did a great job scouting Mike Tomlinson this past week. They would have watched, I'm sure, a lot of film on the way he hits and exactly how to block his hits. And they've done a tremendous job of limiting his success.
Shearhorn comes in for Tomlinson to serve because Tomlinson has really struggled back there. And Shearhorn hits Brunette with the serve. So that's not really the substitution that you wanted if you're Brenda Willis. Goyer. Did it clip the block? No. Gaels desperately need to try and get the momentum back that they had at the end of the second set, start of the third, as Shearhorn goes out, and Queens might need an early timeout, or this possible upset's going to get away from them. Short set, and that time Alexander blocked it. And the timeout by Queens. 6-2 McMaster early in the fourth set. And the Gaels in danger of getting rolled out in this one.
Yeah, interesting that Brenda Willis opted to replace Mike Tomlinson with Tyler Shearhorn. instead of doing what she's done in some of the previous sets where they sub in Thomas Ellison for Mike Tomlinson and put in Sheerhorn for Jamie Wright, so they have the backcourt center and three attackers in the front court. Right now with just two attackers in the front court, McMaster's blocking job is a lot easier.
Interesting dynamic going on here as I'm looking at the Queen's bench. I think Tomlinson upset he's not back in the game, and assistant coach Jackson Dakin, or was that Gabe DeGroot? One of them, I believe it was DeGroot, went over to talk to Tomlinson and tell him why he's not on the floor right now. And he's put on his jacket, but he was very upset at not being sent back in for Sheerhorn. And now Trent with a poor reception. And the problem here for head coach Brenda Willis is after that exchange with Tomlinson, you really can't go back to Tomlinson in this set.
No, you can't reward a player for that kind of behavior.
Goye blocked. McMaster's coming on, and the Gaels are sort of getting caught in the tidal wave. From the back row, Coppers. Herbert. And the Marauder machine is rolling. It's 9-2. Is she going to go to Tomlinson? No. Holmes is going to come in next. Goye ends that run. And you know Brenda Willis has been through this. In all her years of coaching, I'm sure there's been an occasion where a player hasn't agreed with a substitution decision. So she'll take care of it when this match is over, but it's certainly unraveling, if you will, on the Gaels at a bad time as a long serve by Goye.
Yeah, just as McMaster is showing why they're the number one team in the OUA, Queens is falling apart a little bit.
Trent did a good job just to get that over the net. Good save, Goye, but Marr puts it back down. Set for Alexander, and he pounds it in. It's 12-3, and the Gaels are going to use their second and final timeout. And good to see Mike Tomlinson, the first sub there, to congratulate the group coming off. He's competitive. He just needed a few minutes probably to cool off. Wouldn't you agree, Peter?
Yeah, he seems to have found his head there after that explanation from the assistant coach. And now holding a substitution paddle.
Windsor plays Nipissing. Is playing Nipissing right now. So they could move ahead of the Gaels. But then Windsor plays York tomorrow while the Gaels go to RMC, so they could be back to tied by the end of the weekend. Herbert to serve. Right from the back row, Goye. Nice work by Herbert. Free ball from Coppers. Trent. Coppers, be another free ball for the Gaels. So the Gaels have come out of this timeout with a little more life. Short set, and there's Brunette. That had been missing for a bit. And Edwards will return. Just looking at Windsor's schedule, the final week of the season, they'll finish at Guelph and at Waterloo, while the Gaels get Ryerson and Toronto. So certainly the schedule would favor the Gaels. Other than today. And a point for the Gaels. That's why today would have been a really nice upset, because it probably would have not locked the playoff spot, but put them definitely in complete control of it. Coppers from the back row. But still, the Gaels finishing with Ryerson, who right now sits in fifth. Toronto, RMC, who are both in the bottom of the division after today. Shearhorn, and that's out. 14-5 for Windsor. They get Nipissing today, but after that they play second place Waterloo, ninth place Guelph, and fourth place York.
Service error coming from Mark.
And Tomlinson returned, so that's a good sign. We'll see how he responds. And Marr just bangs it off the block and out. With a 9-point lead, it's going to be tough to catch McMaster. It's tough to catch anyone in this conference, let alone the best team.
Yeah, especially now that they seem to have found their rhythm finally in this game.
Trent's on a bad set by Wright. And we go to the technical timeout, but unlike the other three sets, McMaster's in complete control.
Yeah, it seems like they have five hitters all the time they can set.
Yeah, that's a great point. It, you don't know who's being set for. While the Gaels, it's pretty much three players.
Yeah, and the Gaels haven't had the best passing today because of the tremendous serves and hits that McMaster's put up. So Queen's really having to rely on a pretty basic attack, whereas McMaster has been disguising all kinds of plays, putting up tandems with a fake in the front and the guy coming over top in the back row, or two players crossing in the middle so that you lose your man when you're trying to block. Just really, we're seeing why McMaster is number one in the conference and number one in the country.
Karimi's going to come in for Alexander to serve for McMaster, and Wright will get replaced by Ellison. Master by 10 in the fourth set of a match they lead 2-1. Tomlinson, set, Elliott bangs it off the block. Trent's blocked, Edwards, and he went in the net. Turns and apologizes to Campion Smith for running into him. But McMaster now, it just seems like a matter of time before this match is over.
It's funny how the tides have turned here after we were talking upset early.
Yeah. Great save by Marr. Edwards pounds it. Alexander will come back in for Karimi.
Alexander back in.
And Marr wants the wet spot cleaned up from where he dove. These guys work hard. On both teams. Trent. Good serve. Herbert somehow found a spot between the block.
Mar from the back row. Tomlinson, good job. Goyer, did that go off the block? No, it went out on its own. And another point for the Marauders. Campion Smith back to serve. Fourth year out of Bowmanville. Goyer, again the block threw him off. Coppers, and it's blocked into him. And so the Gaels get a point. And Tomlinson, something to cheer about. It's been one of those afternoons, as we've said numerous times, for the Gaels All-Star. Short set, Elliott pounds it. Good save by Edwards and Trentz. But this time, Elliott makes sure no one was getting that one. Gaels have no timeouts left. The Marauders lead by 11 and are 6 points away from the match. Coppers to serve. Just out. Good late reaction by Goyer not to play that. They gave the point on the wrong side. Should be 19-9 for the Marauders. Tomlinson into the net.
Tomlinson usually about even for service aces versus service errors, but tonight the error is certainly winning out.
Poor pass, but then hit out by Alexander. Gaels got away with one there. And it's 20-10.
Gaels back on the board. Phil Goyer to serve.
Goyer to serve. Alexander off the short set. And it's now 4 points from the match for McMaster. Herbert back to serve. Second year player out of Mississauga. Ellison sets for Trentz, and it's out. And an ace for Herbert. Goyer and Dramov just both stepped aside for the other one. And that pretty much tells you the Gaels are a beaten team. 2 points from the match for McMaster. Good block. Tomlinson found a spot. So the Gaels still haven't been beaten. 23-11. Brunette to serve. But the Gaels have to climb Mount Everest with their hands. Good save, Brunette. Trentz off the block. Good play, Coppers. Herbert from the back row gets blocked. Ellison off the block. Herbert recovers. Good rally here late in this match. From the back row, Goyer with the tip. Marr crushes it. Match point, and 13 of them for the Marauders. And guess who's going to serve?
Just who you don't want to see back there.
Yeah, I was just going to say. Stephen Marr, he of the Rocket. Serve. Out! The Gaels cling to hope.
Ellison to serve.
The set. Coppers wrong footed. Gaels have a play here. Edwards through the block. set, coppers, in match, McMaster. The first three sets were exciting. 25-21 McMaster, 25-22 Gaels, 25-20 McMaster. But the life was taken out of the Gaels after that third set, Peter, and they roll to a 25-13 win in the fourth set. They win the match 3-1 and improve to 16-1 overall in the OUA, while the Gaels fall to 6-11. And this, at least in the fourth set, was a clinic by McMaster.
Yeah, it was. It almost seemed like the teams were an inverse of each other. We saw McMaster getting better as the match went on, and Queens getting worse. And it almost seemed like in that fourth set, Queens realized they were playing the number one team in the country and retreated into themselves and didn't play like they did earlier on with the same kind of energy.
It's a disappointing end to what started off as quite an exciting match. The afternoon doubleheader ends with the Gaels losing both matches to McMaster, the women in five, the men in four. A reminder, we're back around 6 o'clock. It's a 6 p.m. tip-off. The women's basketball team and the men's basketball team playing Laurentian in a doubleheader. Remember to switch your to the next game feed if you want to watch the basketball game. Until 6 o'clock, for the entire Queens TV crew and Peter Reimer, I'm Bill Miklas. Thanks for watching an afternoon of volleyball doubleheader, courtesy of Queens TV.